Right. Audacity. Fraps. Tomb Raider 3. Notes. Pen. Drink. Lara's home. Welcome to the final part of my Let's Play of Tomb Raider 3. Back in Lara's mansion after all this bloody time. It's been a year, about 9 months I think, since I started this Let's Play. Crikey. But yeah, we're finally back here for some reflection time. After actually travelling the length of Tomb Raider 3. By far the most difficult Let's Play I've done so far. I recall at the beginning of this Let's Play, people telling me, no way I'd be able to do it. I did it. Did it all without a guide. Pretty proud of myself. So, comparison to Tomb Raider 1, 2, any other games that I've done reflecting on, we're going to do this a little bit differently. I ask you guys to ask me questions as opposed to just going off, you know, what I think you guys would want to hear. It's the best way to do it, in my opinion. And we'll see how it goes. But in the meantime, we still need to crack a few things in this mansion.
Welcome back to my humble abode. Feel free to take a look around.
Thank you very much. How's your adventure been, Lara? You're not going to tell us about it. Okay. She was always wearing that outfit. And why does this little room sound like a jungle? Yeah, there is still a lot to do around her mansion, apparently. According to you guys. Still have no idea what I'm doing, so I'll probably be doing a lot of cutting in this part. You know, running between times where I'm answering these questions and times where I'm actually doing stuff in the game. If you get what I mean. It's going to be merged together. It's literally, this part is going to be stuck together with sellotape. So, where on earth do I start with these questions? I've got a lot, and I've got to say thank you very much for all these. Some of these I never would have thought to have answered, so let's start with this one. So this comes from quite a number of you, actually. Kieran Lochran. I think this is Veggie XP or Vega XP or something like that. Gnarly Punk Rocker 5, Llama Crisps, and Chrissy Doc. And they ask vaguely between them, you know, they've all asked different questions in different manners. So if I call you all out, then I've kind of bundled you all together into the same sort of question. They've asked, which level was my favourite? Generally across the series, let's say, but also in this game. And then which have I found the hardest in the trilogy, you know? So, I think I already revealed my favourite in the previous part. That would be the, I think it's just called, it's called the Tam's Wharf, that's it. That has been my favourite, mainly because of the atmosphere it gives off. But otherwise, I really just like the London segment in general. It's really nice, you know, I think it's really well done. And I think it's a shame that the bonus level wasn't actually kept in, if you get what I mean. Like, because it clearly had a part to do with the London segments. But yeah, that's been my favourite across the entire trilogy, I think. But otherwise, I really like, I like the deck from the second game, though it is a bit flavourless in a way, in the sense that it kind of goes on a bit too long. And I also like St. Francis's Folly from the first game. Now, I'm feeling I haven't actually played around with this before, have I? Like, if I missed this the first time I came in here, I'm quite surprised, because it is blatantly obvious that you can push it. Yeah. How far does this go then? No, it's still blocked. Still blocked. Shit. So what do I do now? I am so confused. So I've pushed that all the way in. Close the door behind me, and there is nothing. Sweet F.A., you know. I don't get what the hell I'm doing here. Thought this would be a nice, easy session, you know. Come away from this game more knowledgeable. more understanding of what kind of features there are in it? No. Makes no fucking difference, apparently. So, in regards to the hardest, surprisingly, is the Indian segment, because it expects far too much from the player. But yeah, I feel that that was the most difficult segment in the entire trilogy, you know, it was insane. Particularly I think it was the third level, either the second or the third. But I did go ahead and make that a lot harder for myself by not using as many save crystals as I should have. But in a way, I'm sort of glad I did do that, because, you know, it's proven to be quite a difficult game overall. So, more generally, Gnarly Punk Rocker 5 actually asked which game has been the hardest of the three, and I think I'm just going to slam that down as being Tomb Raider 3. It is really fucking difficult in comparison to the other two, though that's not to say that the other two are easy in any shape or form. They're really not. Where the hell do I... There must be a key somewhere, because, There's the locked gate in the garden, isn't there? And I really don't have a clue how to get into that. What's this button here? I remember pushing it before, but I don't remember what it does. Oh, right, okay. Second floor, so I don't remember pushing that. I'm thinking of Tomb Raider Legend, actually, with a button being behind the... No, I do remember pushing that. Pretty sure I do. So, what on earth opened over here? Was it this side? No. The other side. Is it? Yeah, there's a lever here, right, okay. I don't know what that opened, though. Oh, did... it... Oh! Did I pull this before and then just completely ignore this or something? Kind of wondering if I did now. Right, let's try that again anyway. So pull. Need to do a roll and run. And literally just dive in there, I guess, because it just... There we go. Actually, the... Oh, really? What, have I got a duck or something? Oh my god, what happened to her body then? That wasn't very pleasant to look at. Wow, Winston actually got in the way there. Whoa. Oh, I made it. Right, so what's this room all about? Oh. There are actual relics in here. Yeah. There's the dagger from the second game. There's the actually, what the hell is that? I don't know what that is, if I'm being honest. That's the Sion from the first game, or Shion, or however you pronounce it. Oh, I think I get what this is. There's expansions for both the first and second game. One of you guys actually did ask, despite the fact I've mentioned it over and over and over, the expansions. It's Masterling TV. Would I consider playing them? I have discussed it quite a lot, but I will remind you that, yes, I am interested in playing them, but I want to leave it. I want to leave it for some years, so that someday I'll have something to come back to, and it'll remind me of the classic Tomb Raider games. So I thought that'd be quite nice, you know, like 2-3 years down the line, be like, oh, I can crack these out and give these a go now. It'll be a nice reminder of what the old Tomb Raiders were like. Droogie1XP asks about Tomb Raider level editor. I've mentioned it a few times. I mean, I mentioned it in Tomb Raider 2 the first time, I think. But Tomb Raider level editor, I do want to start getting into that at some point. I was thinking about doing live streams of it, because I don't think it would be very let's playable, so to speak. But we'll see how things go. Like, I've got other things that I need to get on with in the meantime that I think people would more want to see than that. So here's a fun little thing from the previous level that I did actually draw attention to. What? Oh my god, I just realised there is a head of a T-Rex there as well. So yeah, Dylan56788 mentioned that the corpses in the sewer in the previous level, they may be Sophia Lee's victims. I think that's plausible. I think that's very wise of him to think that, because it does make a lot of sense. No, I'm just gonna fucking use a guide for this from now on, because this is ridiculous. I cannot believe...
You want to look around?
Shut your whore mouth, Lara. Are you kidding me? I can't even fucking see that. How? Just how? Like, this is almost as unforgivable as every single secret there's been in this game so far, you know. This is insane. Holly XO asks, which has been my favourite and least favourite mechanism through the Tomb Raider trilogy? And, I've got to say, like, my favourite has definitely been the minecart. Like, the beginning, I didn't like it too much. It doesn't make a lot of sense gravity-wise and stuff, but overall, it is a lot of fun to use. And my least favourite by a long shot is the bloody kayak. The kayak is horrible. I had someone actually come onto my video and complain, you know, what do you expect? It's a kayak. It's not supposed to function. Fucking hell. It doesn't work like a kayak. It does not work like a kayak at all. It's like, it's so broken and messy, you know. I feel like it was a terrible idea, really, but the kayak section isn't actually that bad overall, so I can't complain too much. Though on the other hand, the little bloody thing in, is it Eldwitch? It's not Eldwitch, is it? It's, Ludd's Gate. Yeah, the stupid underwater thing is horrible as well. But there aren't really that many across the Tomb Raider trilogy, really. I can't really remember any from the second game, aside the boat. So maybe something has skipped my memory that I really didn't like. Nafplay says, Tomb Raider 4 is longer than Tomb Raider 3. How does this make you feel? Well, Nafplays, I'm sweating right now thinking about it, yes. Ray Adam asks a very interesting question. Does Tomb Raider make you feel lonely? It does sometimes, yes. It does very much so. It has that kind of atmosphere about it from time to time. Particularly in, say, the Maria Doria, for example, in the second game, or the, in London. In this game, you know, it really does make you feel a bit cold to a degree, and that's the kind of thing I want out of a game. Now here's a fun little thing from BGates57. They did a little research after I mentioned what the hell an Uli key is that would be in the final level. It was the level before the final level, actually. We had Uli keys, so I was like, what the hell is an Uli key? And he did a bit of research into that, and it turns out it has something to do with tribes that used to reside in Papua New Guinea. There was a cult called Uli or something like that, and the produce that they made were Uli produce, of course. But what on earth would that be doing in Antarctic? So there you go. Like, it wasn't actually something that Core Design invented. Though it could have been something they borrowed, if you get what I'm saying. It is a bit odd, though. Winston, you're in the fucking way. Down here. Come on, can do this. Jump. No, Lara, you stupid woman. Come on. Go, over there, that's it, right. Roll. And it's there. Get in there. Ooh, I just made that, right, okay. Thank fuck for guides. I feel so dirty now, like I've gone through this entire game without using a guide, and I'm finally using a guide in the training level. What? Lara? I remember what used to be down here. There was like a treasury where she kept all the stuff from the first game. That was in the second game, but now? There's an aquarium. Stuart Clark 2007 asks, out of all the Tomb Raider characters, which has been your favourite? Wow, yeah, so much choice. So many Tomb Raider characters. So Lara Croft. There's... No, I'm just kidding. I know, there's Alistair, there's Zip, there's Sophia Lee, there's Natla. There are quite a number of people, really. They're just very minor in comparison to Lara, really, in a sense, apart from Zip and Alistair. Apart from them being a legend. I think they're in another game before them, but I don't really know much about it, to be honest, obviously, because I've not played it. But yeah, my favourite character has to be either Alistair or Sophia Lee. I feel Sophia Lee had more potential to be a better villain than, say, Natla. she just had that kind of personality to her, that kind of grit behind her. It was kind of, she was a cool character. And also I found out both her and Lara are voiced by the same person in this game as well. But otherwise, I like Alistair because he's a bit, he reminds me of myself, in a sense, in Tomb Raider Legend he did anyway, so there you go. GMG7 asks, is my interest in the series wavering or is it still going strong? I can say it is still... Oh, okay, I'm actually in the aquarium now. I hope to hell that these are angel fish and she's not actually put a load of piranha down here, because I would cry a bit if that was the case. I can say it is still going strong, very much so, but I will want to take a break from Tomb Raider, from classic Tomb Raider to be more specific. GMJ7 also asks, the Tomb Raider fandom is unified when it comes to watching Tomb Raider Let's Plays. Am I worried that my channel might be typecast as a Tomb Raider channel? No, not at all. Wait, there's no breathing hole at all? Oh shit, there isn't either. I might actually drown in my own aquarium. I did see something down there just a moment ago, but I don't know what it was. I'd cut these corners very tightly here. It's great that obviously I've got my Tomb Raider fans, but also, you know, I want to keep pleasing my Resident Evil fans. And hopefully I'm planning to pick up a few more along the way, you know, and I want to start getting into more modern games, really, so... But yeah, it's not a worry of mine at all. Not a worry at all. So yeah, there was an item down there on the other side. Over here, what's that? Is that a really enormous key or what? It is, it's the key. Racetrack key, there we go. Right. So here's a cool set of questions. This comes from Silly Sphere, Retro Raider, and MadBuck101. So the first question goes, how much of an improvement was Tomb Raider 3 on Tomb Raider 2 and 1? And I've got to say, vastly. I feel Tomb Raider 3 is a huge, huge improvement on them. You know, it's excellent. I love it. You know, the mechanic, everything seems a bit more, slightly more fluid than Tomb Raider 2 and 1. And if I was to go back and play 1, I think I'd struggle to actually enjoy it now. On the basis that I'm just used to playing Tomb Raider 3. And I really hope that the fourth game, I don't know how it's going to do it, but I really hope that it does improve on 3 and mechanics and stuff. Though I do know that... The fourth game was where Core Design actually decided to move things over to the PC, so I have no doubt that it's better in some ways, because obviously they must have realized at that point that the PC is a much better thing to do Tomb Raider on overall. So I think it was Silly Sphere who asked this, but if someone, and this is an excellent question, if someone were to play this game for the first time blindly, what would I say to them? I'd say it's doable. It's a tough game. It's a tough game, and you've got to have a lot of patience.
Hey, I like the look of this.
Well, I imagine you actually had this made in your garden, so...
To jump on, walk up to the vehicle and press the
action. Oh my god, she's actually tutoring me on how to do it. This feels so stupid. Like, why would they do this? Make it so hard to actually get here, and then act like it's part of the tutorial still. It seems so silly. Alright, let's give this a go anyway.
Let's go as fast as we can.
Alright, I'm going as fast as we can. I don't know why your voice just cut out. Well, this is pretty awesome though. Still, like, I don't feel the controls are the best for doing this kind of stuff. If you get what I'm saying, like, it's... Oh, wow. It's quite large as well. Before I move on to the final question, I have one question that I'm surprised none of you guys asked. You know, I went to London before everything else, as opposed to going to Nevada because I knew by that point it'd make the game easier. Yeah, I'm really surprised none of you were like, well, how did you find it? Do you think it was better? Do you think you enjoyed the game more as a result? And, you know, fuck yeah, I enjoyed the game more, because I feel like I've literally set myself more of a challenge and completely, you know, busted it. And I really don't think you need to do Nevada first, if you get what I'm saying. The number of items you have if you went to Nevada first and ended up in the, obviously, the Antarctic last, by the time you got to the final boss, you'd have far too many items. You'd have way more than you would ever need. But the doing the London first, followed by, I can't remember, the islands, whatever it was, South Pacific, that's it, followed by Nevada, hardest route, apparently. It wasn't that hard. It wasn't that much of a challenge, really, but it was fun. I really enjoyed it, you know, losing all my items and stuff and struggling with the Antarctic a little bit more than perhaps I should have. Yeah. Like I said, I'm surprised no one actually asked me about that. Let's see how quickly I can do this circuit.
See how quickly the assault course can be completed. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Okay. It's the true test of whether I've actually mastered this game or not. Let's do this shit. Here we go. Watch me fail at the first jump. Oh, maybe I could have jumped that without actually, you know. Oh well. Never mind. Come on. No! How did I miss that? Oh well, whatever. Come on, keep going. There's no way I can do as bad as I did right at the beginning of the game because I actually left the track. So the final question. Final question. I've been asked this by many, many, many people, and I cannot, obviously, just give you all a shout-out for this, but thank you very much for partaking in this. What game do I plan to do now, and what games would I plan to do in future? Now, I don't think it's any secret. I want to do every single Tomb Raider game, pretty much. There is not one that comes to mind that I think, no, I don't want to play. Aside from, perhaps, I don't know, I did hear there's like games on the Game Boy and stuff like that that I never heard of before, actually. I didn't realise there were like other games aside the main series. Might do those in a blind brief. That'd be cool, wouldn't it? But what a lot of you guys want me to say Tomb Raider 4 next. I'm very sorry to say that I've been having a lot of trouble getting Tomb Raider 4 working to the point where it's been irritating as shit. Like, infuriatingly hard to get working. Of course, it's a game on the PC. My laptop did not, from the word go, want to run it. And myself and Stella and Sardok, thank you very much to both of those, have tried our absolute best to get it working, but to no avail so far. I swear, overall, put about 80 hours into this. 80 hours into getting a fucking game working. So you can probably imagine how pissed off I am at it. So, you know, I thought, well, what can I do? I'll go emulate it on PS1. Tried emulating it on PS1. It looks shit. It looks absolutely shit in comparison to the PC version. I'm not going to lie, it looks horrible. Because this game, Tomb Raider The Last Revelation, it is designed for the PC. You can clearly see that when you go to play it. Come on, Lara, get on it. Oh, really? Well, I don't think anyone's going to beat this. Oh, Jesus Christ. I have put far too much effort into it. At this rate, like, if I continue to put as much effort into it as I have been in the past, there is no way I'm going to be able to get on with any more games. So I thought, for now, I'll just leave Tomb Raider 4 alone, get on with something else, and then come back to it later. So we're talking about a break here. We're talking about a break from the classic Tomb Raider. How long will that be? I'm going to say a few months. And I know a lot of you won't be happy to hear that. I'm really, really sorry, but I hope you can understand like the amount of effort I've put into this and how frustrating it is. But if all else fails, we'll just go with the emulated version. Hopefully that'll work out nicely. I still don't bloody know if that does, to be honest. I only tested it a little bit. Yeah, have some of that, Winston. Come on. So close. Got this. Let's see what my time is. It's going to be amazing. Let's end this with a V. Really? 4 minutes 31 seconds. Comment if you can beat that, because I think I've beat the world record right there. For Queen and Country, this is the pinnacle of my Tomb Raiding skills. What you can expect, is a couple of newer Tomb Raider games over the next couple of months or so. I'm going to try and get through them as quickly as possible. Then I will have another crack at getting Tomb Raider 4 working. like I said, the rest of the series, yes. Yes, every game. Every game I want to do. I want to do Tomb Raider. I want to do the Guardian of Light. I want to do Temple of Osiris. I want to do Angel of Darkness. I want to do Chronicles. I want to do The Last Revelation. I want to do all the expansions. I want to give Tomb Raider Level Editor a go in some shape or form. And even these bloody spin-offs that I've been on about. So everything. I want to do it. No need to ask me. So, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this Let's Play. Thank you so, so much for the support you've shown me. It's been colossal. It's time to turn the page, start a new chapter, so to speak. I'll see you again in the future, hopefully. Time to finish this exactly how I finished my Tomb Raider 1 Let's Play. Thanks for watching, and...
Right, let's go and play outside.
What? No, that's wrong. God, she said everything pretty much the same up to now. Fine, stay wet, you stupid bind. Till you join me again, guys. Take care of yourselves, and thank you so much for joining me for Tomb Raider 3.